Hello all, welcome to bhpsolutions.com. My name is Amit and today I'm going to show you how to take a backup, recovery, how to migrate your Airspace Cube between environment. In today's session, we are going to use a lifecycle management utility. This is exists in your shared service. We will be using the latest version of Hyperion PS3 called Hyperion 11.1.2.3 so that I could demonstrate you what are the new features are available with your LCM. We'll do this in two steps. In the first part of our presentation, I'll walk you through with how to migrate or take a backup or restore your Airspace Cube manually. And the second part of this, I'll show you how to automate the same activity. So let's get started. What is LCM? LCM is very popular method or means these days to take a backup of your different Hyperion application artifacts, entire application or individual application artifacts, or restore. You can also migrate your application from between your environment. You can migrate your application from file system to your application, whole application or subset of the application, including your data as well. The latest release allow you to backup your Airspace Cube data as well. In this diagram, I'm going to show you a simplest diagram which shows the left from Airspace to file system. Basically, I'm going to show over here how to take a backup. From file system to Airspace is a restore, right? So I'll take a backup manually, then delete the application and restore. And in this example, I also demonstrate you it not only restore the entire application, but the Airspace Cube data as well. Well, so I'm going to use one of my sample application called sample. This ship along with Airspace. This application, I load some sample data, right? So before backup and after backup, I could show you what data it has. Let me quickly show you one sample data which I loaded. I'm using AMDS query. When I process this, I could see some set of data over here. Combination of your two sets, January, budget, New York, cola sales, right? What I do, I'll take a backup of this cube and then delete this the entire application and restore it. And post restore, I will check, do I get the data as well or not? I could restore the entire application or subset of the application. I would show you, I'll restore the entire application. Well, you can invoke this LCM utility from your workspace. The URL of your workspace is HTTP, name of your server, or IP address of your server 28080, and workspace. The default user is admin and password is password. I'll invoke my shared service from my workspace. You see in the bottom there's an option called shared service console. Invoke this and under application group you find all the application. There's a folder called Airspace cluster 1. A cluster 1, you may have cluster 2, cluster 3, there are multiple clusters. You can also move your application between clusters, right? In this example, my source application sample, just double click, it will filter, listed out all the folders and files to be backed up. It takes few seconds to read all the application structure. So what you see over here, there are five folders and the folder called configuration, custom defined function, macros, database and substitution variable. In database, I can see there are three databases in my application under sample, basic and other two databases. All these databases would be listed out over here. It takes little time to read it. I could specify what subset or what part of Airspace Cube I would like to take a backup. I can further expand this and say my database in turn consists of calculation, script, rules, reports and other elements. So whatever object you want to take a backup, you select them. In this case, in my example, I'm going to select the entire cube and just simply click on export. What does export do? It converts the entire application into in terms of XML in the predefined structure. So specify folder structure, a folder, I would call this Airspace backup 11th August Airspace backup, right? So it is easy for me to recognize 11th August Airspace backup. Just click on export option, it will invoke your backup, click on export. The moment you click export, it creates a folder in your import export folder. So I'll show you what the folder structure over there. There's a folder called user project. It is under, this is under your EPMA, it middleware home. On the middleware home you find called user project, under you find system, EPM system 1, and there's a folder called import export. In import export you see there's a folder got created called 11 August as space backup. You find there's a remarkable difference between the previous release if you experience in LCM and the new release. The LCM file creates a zip file, so entire Space Cube turns out to be zip file. I can unzip it and see what all artifact it consists of. So I'll extract over here, it will extract a folder. I double click and see all my required stuff. So I need to see two important file over here, import.xml and export.xml. Let me open the import.xml and show you. Import.xml, this is a structure of my import.xml file. What thing you should pay attention over here, the username and password is empty, it is not passed. I wanted my username and password. My password should be encrypted so people cannot open and see this. And in addition to this, there are five folders, the same folder which I shown you during application backup, configuration, custom defined function and all. And the folder structure is recursive and it will read all the file, star shows all the file under this folder recursively. Right, now open this file. I'll convert this file, I'll just convert the username and password into encrypted format. Right, so what I do first, in addition to this you can also browse to other folders. Other folders called info and resources. Resources are same folder. If you would like to know what files to be backed up or restored, there's a file called listing.xml. This file give you a list of all the files to be backed up and all folder exists in folder and file as well. See the structure over here, we have got resource ID, which is ID, name of your object and object path and type of it. It is data, is a text file, calculation script, rule scripts, whatever it is. This file could be, you can use as a master file which talk about what all your Space Cube consists of. Right? You also see there's an element called data. So with this version as well, we can start taking a backup of your data as well, Space Cube data. Right? Now I'm going to see, you can also open in your browser and see what was your last migration. Under administration, there's an option called migration status report. Click on this and when you refresh it, the latest activity which I did, I invoke this. My source was sample application and target was my file system. Right? This is what I executed just a 2 minutes before. Alright, so what I do now, I invoke a utility called utility.xml, utility.sh. What does this file do? This file will first it will invoke import.xml and encrypt my password. Right? You can see this file under import export in your bin folder in the user project. There's a bin folder and this is the file. I'll invoke this file utility.sh, right? And I pass my XML as a parameter. Okay, let me open this in a terminal. I'm already into this folder location. I'll call this utility.xml and I pass my XML file over there which I stored. Let me copy the path. This is my file. Let me copy this path and I pass it there. So you see I invoke my utility.sh and pass import.xml as my parameter. Click enter and hit it go on. I'll pass my username and password. And this time it will convert my, encrypt my password. You see import process is going on. It will take an import of all my stuff. Well, in this case, I already imported this and I did not delete my my application. So it will overwrite my sample application. You see all import is going on, including your data, text file, basics and all, right? Once this is my migration got completed, and what I like you to pay attention first, look at my import file, import.xml. Double click on import.xml. What you see over here, in the previous example, the password was empty and it got encrypted now. I use this file to automate my further activity. Right? I like to import it once again, and this time before importing it, I will delete my application. Right? So let's delete this application and restore. The last example was backup, and backup got created in my folder structure. I could see my backup file over here. Do you see that? A backup file, a zip version and unzip version. Right? So I have a backup in my file system. I do the reverse way from file system to my application. Before we restore, I'll delete this file. Or I simply rename it with other name. Let's rename this with other name. I'll rename for O for old and restore my file. It is also possible you can restore to separate different application. In this example, we restore the same application. That require your XML file to be modified. Right? So now let's manually restore it. To manually restore it, it's pretty easy. Just invoke your zip file and restore it. It takes a little time to open. So open your backup file, select the folder which you want to take a backup. You can backup entire application or subset of the application as you take to export of entire application. I like to take a backup of, restore of entire application. This is my backup copy, select all and import back. In which application you want to import, define your target application. It could be sample, or I could give a different name as well. Because this time I'm doing manually, I select all through my interface. Click on import, import will take on. It takes some time. It's in progress. It takes few more seconds to import it. Right? So let it go on. Once import is done, we'll check our application and also check the data got imported or not. Well, what do you see over here? You can see live what objects are being imported out of 77 artifacts. 38 artifacts are being imported. I keep on refreshing it and see. It may also possible to partially import. So my entire file got imported, right? No error. I could see it. And it's done at 1720 just now. So I'll quickly manually check my entire application. Go to my Airspace administration server and manually check. Right click and refresh. I see my sample application available over here. I see my database and other artifacts. Because this version not only import or restore entire application, but also restore data as well. Now I query this and see. This is the instance before exporting, and this is the value after importing. Right? So I could import or restore my data as well in addition to my other application artifacts. So the whole activity I did it manually. Now I want this to be done automated. Automated is pretty simple. You call utility.sh and pass your import file, and you can put into a batch file or shell file and schedule it. You can use a Windows scheduler, or you can use a Linux scheduler, cron tab, whatever method you like to do it. So let's do this once again. This time I'm going to automate this with my command prompt. I delete this application once again, and I'm going to import this through a command utility. So what do you do? Just invoke it once again. In case you want to import in some other application, you can modify the XML file and do that as well. Right? That's possible. So what do you do? Under import file, you see your application name is sample. Right? If you want to restore a separate application, just change the name of it. I right click and edit it and change the name of it. I would add it in a gedit. Edit this file and change the name of my application. I call new app. new sample. Make sure it shouldn't be more than 8 character long. New samp, right? So this import file being read when you import it. Once again, I call this file through my shell script, and I would put just this shell script in. I can associate this shell script with my scheduler. Once again, I call this file. So utility.sh, which is under bin, and this is my file name under user project, name of your backup file or folder, and import.xml. Put it. Now this is go on. I can go back and look at the log file of import log file and get to know that what is being happened behind the screen. Okay. It will take few more seconds. Let it complete. Meanwhile, you can see your admin window as well as administration console and see a new application. It is still being created. You should be able to see a new application got created over here. So let it complete. Yeah, the migration just started. What I see when I refresh it, I see my new folder, new application got created, right? And the folders are being created also. Import is going on, right? It is importing all the artifacts step by step. So the two line of instruction which I put over here, I simply create new shell file and put it over there. Let this complete and I check it. My import done successfully. I could see, and I'm going to query my data in addition to my artifacts. I could manually check this, my set of calculation script, reports and all. Right? I could see all the objects are, got imported into a new application called new sample. You see we modify import.xml file and given a new name. Now I'll check my data as well. New sample.basic. Just to ensure that did I restore data as well. When I process, I see the data is also there. I did not lose my data. So this way you can backup and restore your application from Sbase Cube to file system, and file system restored back to your Sbase Cube. Same Sbase Cube, or you can change an Sbase name, new application name, right? You can migrate to new environment as well. You just need to carry this file and put into your import export and your folder, respective folder structure. Well, in order to automate this, you don't need to do much. Just take this file, whatever we run. I just copy this whole instruction. Copy this whole instruction. And I create my shell file. Gedit. I paste it over here. I give the full path of my utility.sh, full path, and I save this file. I can invoke this shell file through a command prompt or shell terminal, or I can associate with my scheduler. So let me give you a full path of this folder under bin. This is the full path. I just copy the stuff, a full path from here. That's it. I think I close it. Well, so my shell script is ready. I'll go to this folder, bin folder, and call utility.sh and pass this file as my parameter, import.xml. That's it. Save this with sh extension. I put it under my desktop, whatever name you want to give. I say automate restore .sh. That's it. You can call this file with your cron tab or whatever scheduler you like to use it. So you see how easy it is to take a backup and restore of your Sbase Cube, including your data. You can manually do this, or you can invoke this shell file which automate your activity. So in addition to Sbase, you can use lifecycle management utility to take a backup or restore of your IPM planning, reporting component, financial management, and other dimension housed in your EPMA. So thanks for watching today's session. Do subscribe to our YouTube channel and write to me if you have any question. My email ID is, you can email to us in support.bhpsolutions.com. Thank you.